Back in the 1990s, Mitsubishi had a lot of awesome compact performance cars, namely the Evo, Galant, and Eclipse. Back then, those cars kicked ass, and today they're still a great platform to build off of. The engine under the hood is well known for being super tough and being able to withstand huge amounts of boost and create a ton of power. Today, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about the 4G63. 4G63 follows the same basic formula that a lot of high-performance four-cylinder engines follow. That's a 2-liter, four-cylinder, dual overhead cam engine with a turbo strapped to it and a ton of boost. Although it follows the same basic formula of a lot of other high-performance four-cylinder engines, it's what's inside this engine that makes it special. For this video, we're going to talk about the 4G63T, not the naturally aspirated 4G63. The 4G63 is part of Mitsubishi's Sirius engine family, which followed the naming scheme that they used back then. The 4 refers to the number of cylinders, G stands for gasoline, the 6 refers to the engine family, and the 3 refers to the engine itself. T is obviously for turbocharged. This is a group of engines which started all the way back in 1976 and was in production all the way up until 2013. It can be found in a bunch of different vehicles, especially the naturally aspirated version. Like I said earlier, the specific version we're going to talk about is a 4G63T, which is the turbocharged variant that's found in a lot of Mitsubishi's performance cars of the 1990s. This engine features an 85mm bore, 88mm stroke, dual overhead cams, turbocharger, cast iron block, and cast aluminum cylinder head. From the start of its life, the 4G63T was designed as a race engine, and the first 4G63T in the US came about from Mitsubishi's participation in rally racing. The first cars in the US to use these engines were the first generation DSMs, which includes the Mitsubishi Eclipse, Eagle Talon, and Plymouth Laser. The 4G63T found in those early DSMs isn't particularly powerful by today's standards at 195 horsepower, but back then it was a pretty respectable power figure. In 1992, the US 4G63T was revised to match the Japanese market Evo, which featured different piston oil squirters and a lighter rotating assembly. In 1995, the second generation DSMs came around, and with it, a revised version of the 4G63T, which now output 210 horsepower. Continuing their rally racing development, the 4G63T was eventually used in the Mitsubishi Lancer after Mitsubishi dropped the Galant VR4 in 1993. Over the years and the different generations of the Evo, the 4G63T received a few different revisions every time, making a little bit more power. What makes this engine very special is the architect that you'll find inside and the components that Mitsubishi used. To put it simply, the bottom end of this engine is known for being insanely strong and being able to withstand huge amounts of boost pressure and make respectable power numbers. Starting with the block, it uses a very basic and low-tech cast iron design. And although it might be low tech, it features a lot of material in all the right places, and it's known for being able to withstand huge power numbers. Even with a built bottom end, the stock block is typically not a limiting factor. The earlier 4G63Ts found in the first generation DSMs are known as the 6-bolt engines because of the 6 bolts that they use to hold the flywheel to the crankshaft. The 6-bolt engines use massive and thick connecting rods, very wide and beefy rod and main caps, and an insanely low 7.1 to 1 compression ratio. On top of that, it uses a forged steel nitride coated crankshaft. The pistons are cast, but they feature a very strong design with very low and wide rings for extra rigidity. As mentioned earlier, there are oil squirters in the bottom end of this engine, which spray oil up at the bottom of the piston dome to help keep things cool. What makes this engine special is that the first and second and fourth and fifth main caps are tied together rather than being separate like a normal engine. The stock components on these 6-bolt engines were insanely strong but also very heavy, and each following version of the 4G63T used lighter rotating assemblies to improve efficiency. Now, the 6-bolt engine was basically designed to run in boost, and when it's not in boost, it's a very lethargic and underpowered engine. This is partially because of the extremely low compression ratio. After the 6-bolt engine came the 7-bolt engine, which featured a lot of notable differences compared to the 6-bolt. And one of the biggest changes was the jump in compression ratio all the way up to 8.5 to 1. This made the 7-bolt a lot more powerful out of boost and ultimately more efficient. The piston rings were redesigned and sealed better, the rod and main bearings were narrowed to decrease friction, and lighter rods were used to decrease rotational mass inside the engine. The main bearings changed from multiple paired caps to one large casting, which theoretically makes the bottom end a lot stronger. Now, there are a bunch of other small changes from the 6-bolt to the 7-bolt engine, but ultimately it was all about making the rotating assembly lighter and making the entire engine more efficient, but it did come at at the cost of a very slightly weaker engine. No discussion of the 4G63T would be complete without talking about crank walk, which is a problem that the internet has blown out of proportion when it comes to the 7-bolt. Early 7-bolt engines are known for excessive thrust bearing wear, which over time, when they wear down, allows the crankshaft to move back and forth in the block. The reasons for crank walk have been debated since it was first reported, but for the most part, it's been completely blown out of proportion and it's not nearly as big of a problem as many people claim it is. The design, shape, and flow of the cylinder head is one of the keys when it comes to making power, and with the 4G63T, Mitsubishi actually did a pretty decent job designing the cylinder head on all different versions of this engine. The earlier 1G intake ports are huge, and it's often argued that the 1G head is actually better than the 2G head because of the port size, but looks can be deceiving because port size isn't everything. While the 2G head does have smaller ports, they had a straighter design and provide better air velocity. In pretty much all applications other than massive turbo race cars, the 2G head is actually better because it provides more power throughout the entire rev range. Now, the last version of the cylinder head used on the Evo 9 actually used a design similar to the 2G head, further proving the point that the 2G head is just better for street use. Now, it should be noted that the Evo 9 version of this head featured MyVec, which is Mitsubishi's variable valve timing system. If you want to make big power on any 4G63, the stock turbocharger is definitely going to be a limiting factor. Throughout the years, Mitsubishi used a handful of different turbochargers, but pretty much all of them really can't push much farther than 5 psi past their stock output. For a decently powered street car though, stock turbos are actually really good because they provide really good throttle response and a decent amount of low and mid-range torque, while still being able to get upwards of 300 wheel horsepower in some applications. Now, one of the most common upgrades is the 16G turbo, which was used on some overseas Evo models and provides enough flow to easily get around 300 wheel horsepower. If you want even more power, the 20G turbo, which comes from Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, is another good solution, but at this point, throttle response starts to suck, but you're gonna be able to make a lot of power. Now, for those who want even more power, there are massive turbochargers on the aftermarket, and it's really easy to build up the bottom end of this engine to withstand upwards of 800 wheel horsepower or more. And the absolute peak of drag racing, it's common to see 4G63Ts with fully billet blocks and built engines making 1,000 to 1,500 wheel horsepower, possibly even more. And some of these engines make upwards of 100 PSI of boost. To wrap this all up, it's easiest to just remember that the 4G63T was designed as a race engine first with Mitsubishi's Rally Racing Ventures, and it features an insanely strong bottom end design. Unlike other four cylinders, which rev really high but don't make a lot of low end torque, 4G63T is the other way around from other four cylinders at the time in the fact that it makes a lot of low end power and a lot of mid range power, but it doesn't rev very high, so it doesn't make a massive amount of peak power. So that's just about everything you need to know about the 4G63T engine. Drop a comment down below if you think I missed anything or if there's anything you want to add. Be sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.